pitfall that doesn't necessarily affect correctness, but may impact performance is what we call spurious or unnecessary wake-ups. Let's look at this code for a writer and readers. Let's say currently there is a writer that's performing a write operation. So it is the one that has the lock counter mutex. So this is the shared lock. And then elsewhere in the program, readers, for instance, are waiting on a condition variable read phase. So there are a number of readers that are associated with the wait queue that's part of that condition variable. So what can happen when this writer issues the broadcast operation, this broadcast can start removing threads from the wait queue that's associated with the read phase condition variable. And that can start happening perhaps in another core before the writer has completed the rest of the operations in the lock construct. Now, if that's the case, we have the writer on one core. It holds still the lock and it's executing basically this portion of the code. And at another core, on another CPU, the threads that are waking up from this queue that's associated with the condition variable that's part of the wait statement, they have to, the very first thing they do is they have to reacquire the mutex. We explained this before. So that means the very first thing that these threads will do will try to reacquire the mutex. The mutex is still held by the writer thread. The writer thread still has the mutex. So none of these threads will be able to proceed. They'll be woken up from one queue that's associated with the condition variable, and they'll have to be placed on the queue that's associated with the mutex. So we will end up with this type of situation as a result of this. This is what we call spurious wake-up. We signaled, we woke up the threads, and that wake-up was unnecessary. They have to now wait again. The program will still execute correctly. However, we will waste cycles by basically context switching these threads to run on the CPU and then back again to wait on the wait queue. The problem is that when we unlock only after we've issued the broadcast or the signal operation, no other thread will be able to get the lock. So spurious wakeups is this situation when we're waking threads up, we're issuing the broadcast or the signal, and we know that it is possible that some of the threads may not be able to proceed. It will really depend on the ordering of the different operations. So would this always work though? Can we always unlock the mutex before we actually broadcast our signal? For instance, by using this trick, we can transform the old writer code into this code where we first unlock and then we perform the broadcast and signal operations. This clearly will work just fine. The resulting code will avoid the problem of spurious wakeups and the program remains correct. In other cases, however, this would not be possible. We cannot restructure the program in this way. So if we look at what's happening at the readers, the signal operation is embedded in this if clause, and the if statement relies on the value of resource counter. Now, resource counter was the shared resource that this mutex was protecting in the first place. So we cannot unlock and then continue accessing the shared resource. That will affect the correctness of the program. Therefore, this technique of unlocking before we perform the broadcast or signal doesn't work in this particular case or in similar cases.